Hey, what's going on, guys and girls? Phoenix here, and welcome to episode number 20 of my single player Tarkov Let's Play series. I've figured out Aman's sense and why loose loot items were not highlighting. So if you're using visceral bodies and Aman's sense together, turn off the item physics setting because it affects loose loot highlighting. For whatever reason, it affects it, and I found that comment on the hub. On the Aman Sense Hub, someone put it in the comments section, which was super awesome. So I also did end up buying the MK1 golden keychain, and it cost me a little bit of moolah. So I had a Gingy keychain, I already had the gold chain, so I just needed to buy a second factory key that we could use. So that cost me a little bit of money. I think it was about 130 grand or something like that. Sorry, you heard my daughter walking in. She wanted ice cream. So, yeah, so I brought that. So that cost me a bit of money, but it allows us to put our customs keys, our ground zero keys, and our interchange keys, and a few others in here. And the rest of it, we've got to buy the other two, but we need a cottage key to buy MK2, and I don't have the moolah to do it, and I'm not selling more stuff. We're going to Shoreline, is the plan for today, just so you're aware. We're going to Shoreline, we're gonna kick it on Shoreline, try and do a few markers, get a couple tasks done. I hate Shoreline, but we need to do it. And now that Aman's sense is actually working, maybe we'll be able to spot something that's worth a bit of money if we have to go to the resort at all. Which I believe I do, because I've still got to do signal. Because I cannot ever get out of a Shoreline raid alive, seemingly. I just get wrecked. When I'm thinking about making my way out, I run into 2 or 3 PMCs or something that just popped my head into a watermelon. I should also preface this as well. You got to remember, with my performance in this game, I'm playing with OBS recording using my GPU. So that is going to affect some form of performance as well. Okay, we're spawned back a bit. There's no bosses. Gotta do colleagues and eagle-eyes over that way. Mark the container by cottages. Rigged game. We need to do the medical container at Shoreline, at the health resort, and river pier. I'm going to have to go to Health Resort. I don't want to. It's a very high risk area, but we're going to have to do it because it just has to be done. We have to get that done. But thank you guys and girls for joining me for another episode of Single Player Tarkov. If you enjoy the video, remember to leave a like. And if you want to see more, hit the subscribe button. We're growing exponentially over the last week. It's been awesome to see all the new people. Especially a lot of the people who have been so against single-player Tarkov until BSG pulled the crap that they pulled. I swear I saw someone there then. Okay, we'll just be careful. Probably make our way to resort. We won't take too much time up. Have I got everything hotkeyed, by the way? Yep, it's cool. It's checking. So I'm glad to get Aman's sense going. I thought it was a very obscure thing. I knew there was something wrong, but I couldn't determine what I installed. I was looking at my downloads list, because I, when I download things and they're installed in order and stuff, I know what things went in what order. So I saw Visceral Bodies was near it, and I must have installed it at around the same time, but I didn't think about the item physics setting causing any issues, so... There you go, you learn something new every day. Thank you to Krakona, I think is the name of the person on the hub that actually posted the comment, and I did actually make a Reddit post and a follow-up with the solution, because I know nothing I hate more than when you look up for something on the internet and someone's asked a question and then they go, I found a solution, but they never posted what the solution was. It makes you want to punch them in the head. Retroactively knock them out. So, okay, we did do this one. I'm just checking. We're running past. We got to grow up here anyway for colleagues. Okay. So we're going to have to go to here. Unfortunately, I don't have an extract there though, so I'd have to go there and then go away from there, which is kind of a pain in the ass. Really inconvenient. I just, the only thing I don't like is when quests don't disappear when you've already technically marked it or something. So now I've got to determine what ones are done and what ones aren't, which is really irritating. Like, and they don't give me the notification sound either when I re-trigger them, which makes me even more questioning whether I'd do it. The only reason I know is because the task text pops up. Been pretty quiet so far. I'm a bit worried when we get up to resort, it's just going to pop off like... just gonna go insane. I think our best bet is to try and go up the side and go through the side door of the building. So we don't have to go at the front entrance yet. Because the front entrance of Shoreline is just hell on earth. It's not a good place to be. It's just asking for trouble. Can I please climb the side of this? Yes, I can. I thought I could make my way up the rock wall, but... Come on. Come on, fatty. You can do it. Got him. Wanted to make sure he was dead. Alright, sorry, my daughter came in to say goodnight. Alright, so we're going to make our way in here quickly and see if we can be fine. I don't hear anybody, so I think we're going to be okay. Alright, I think we should just quickly, we'll go up to the top and get the signal source located. So then anything else we do, we don't have to worry about going back on top of the building. We don't want to. Come up here one time quickly, ping it, and then we're good. SP... So you can see I've got it working now with the proper version, because that AKMN is on the table and it's still highlighting. Thank God. It is an odd thing that the item physics thing caused it to have issues, but I mean, it makes sense, but it doesn't make sense because I don't know what actually changed to cause it to disappear with the logo. That's the thing that makes no sense. And the items on the flea that I've been trying to sell don't seem to sell no matter my settings. So I don't know what's broken with my flea market. I have to look into that too. That's another thing I've got to get figured out. But for the now, we got these motor controllers, but I don't know whether I've got the keys I need to get access to the motor controllers or not. I have no idea. We're going to find out. I don't know what floor they're on either. That's the other issue. I don't know whether it tells me. Yeah, so I need 216 and 306 key. I've got 306. I don't know whether I've got 216 on me, though. I don't. I've got 213. Yeah, so I need 216 and 306 or 308. So I can get maybe one or two. We'll see. And see what we can find while we're in here, though. As it seems relatively quiet at the moment, I'm going to take advantage of that. Backup hideout key. Anything in here? retain the fiber, the second single axis fiber optic. Yeah, see? Because I need to get over to that room. One day I'll find a LEDX or something lying around in here. Maybe. Yeah, I need to go through there. Annoying. Like I said, of course, we'll get what we can, but... Shit. It leads to nowhere. Whoopsie! Head back through here, and back down one floor. See what we got lying around in here. I heard a gun. Yellow. Ah, of course, the locked room. Is it 220? It'd be 228, I guess, wouldn't it? Or it could be in the room above it, actually. Is it in the room above it? Yeah, I'm looking at it. This one? Yeah, I can't go through there either. Nope. Okay, I've played a lot of Resort, but remember, it's also, for a lot of this stuff, it's been a couple of years, so my memory's not perfect. By any stretch of the imagination, comparatively to the people who've been playing this every day, but what a shit show BSG's been creating. They made a post a couple of hours ago that somehow sunk themselves into a deeper grave. They just have their hearts set. They really have their hearts set on pay-to-win mechanics being implemented to some degree. Oh, that's annoying. You can see the... You can see it through it. Eh. I didn't mean to reload, by the way. I was trying to peek through to see if I could... Now it's there! God, that's annoying. Alright, so we need 216 as well. We're going to have to try and work on that. I hear all these things, but they're not on my floor. Oop. Ow. Okay. Is there anything I can actually get in this building, or is everything here just stuff that I've got to run over? I've got to get the UAV. I've got to go back that way to do that if I want to do eagle-eyed, which is a little annoying. Like I said, the resort seems so quiet at the moment. I kind of want to take advantage of anything that is here. Yeah, we got to go. We should go mark the medical container and stuff while it's quiet. I'm gonna run past here, see if we get shot at. Okay, because I got it on live like random. So we can have raids where it's quiet, we can have raids where it's crazy. It all varies, so that's the whole point. Sometimes it's just like a late night... Feels like a late night Oceanic server at the moment. You know, it's just kind of quiet, it's not super insane. Until you get shot by a cheater or something. Right, we need to get this shit marked. I'm worried I'm gonna get shot at as we move out here, but... God, I hate this area. Placement ones too. The worst. So much worse than a plant and run. Okay. Ooh, hello. Mm-hmm. I will take CMSs all day. And now we need to run over the top of these boys. Sweet. Anything good in here? Any wonders? It's not worth a lot. The plates, like, getting the plates like that is not efficient. It's so heavy. If you get the armor, then it's fine, but the plate like that is not the way you want to be getting stuff to sell. It's just so heavy. Okay, how do I want to do this? I kind of want to swing my way past Signal and then go down to the pier. That's my plan. Go to Signal, swing down to the pier, and then backtrack my way to Railway Bridge probably and get out. I want to grab Eagle-Eyed from over here. Of course, we haven't done the first one. I guess technically the second UAV because it's back there, but we can always do that in a follow-up raid. And then I only have to worry about doing that one task. We'll try and see if we get enough money to be able to do rigged game as well. Because I think one of the motor controllers is, yeah, out here. So I can grab that on the way out. Like, once we go on to this UAV, we'll grab that, head down to pier as well. All this area is so different. This all just used to be forest, and it used to be nowhere near as wide. I was trying to headshot him, that's why I missed so many fucking shots. That's what I'm worried about, I need cover. Let him shoot. Fuck, I'm glad he missed that shot. That was very close to my face. They were over here questing. Oh my god. Oh. Oh, he's got some good shit on him. And I just sound like I came to him. I'm sorry. Oh, he's got some good fucking shit on him. Fuck off. Okay, doesn't matter which way I put it. There we go. I'll work with it, and then I'll check this guy real quick. If I can find his body, that is. There he is. Quickly do this. We've got to obtain the thingo out of here. Give me that. He had a slick. Why does he have to have a takedown bag and not a wide bag? Slug ammo. Thought I'd check it. I know it doesn't fit, but I'm always like hopeful that it might. Yeah, I probably should do. this way. Because I've got AK mags sitting there. Milk, conditioned milk, drink. Slick's worth more. By a lot. Can I take that stock off? No. Not in raid, not unless I get a mod to do that. Ah, shit. I just can't. I can't even fold it either. I dropped the TX-15. I said screw it. I'd rather the slick, to be honest. It's worth more money. We need to go this way for signal. Holy shit. This map throws me off big time now. Resort used to go across to there. Used to be where the thing I was, I thought. Maybe I'm just misremembering the map now. Or I'm losing my mind. I don't know which. Maybe a bit of both. I mean, it does go towards pier, so that's no problem to me. We can go past and grab this motor controller. It should be in a wood box, if my memory is correct from the past. We'll find it in a little wood box. Gotta watch out for enemies potentially doing the same. Shooting over there. I'm gonna do this really, really quick now. I'm glad the shooting's that way and not up here in front of me. I'm gonna lie down and chill for a sec and get my stam back. Because I think that's what we need to do. Okay. Make our way up there now. Gotta be aware of where I'm going. Because we're doing this. This approach is all different. Trying to see if I can hear anybody. Check up here. We could end up with getting some good stuff, especially out of the safe. There's some beard oil just sitting on the shelf here. Hello. So, that's worth a bit of moolah. Manual, I do need them for the library. So, I guess we'll take it. That. Bit of SAS drive I'll take, and the GP coin I'll take. I'll drink this. And we move these out, so we got room for a mag. I'm not worried about the cash. Not 2 grand. If it was like 20. I mean, need a lot of that stuff, but not right now. We don't. I more came up here to hope there was a GPU in there, because we still have to find GPUs in raid. But no such luck for myself that time. Just trying to make sure I'm kind of tucked away a little bit. Yeah, the flea price doesn't bother me so much, because the flea, like I said, hasn't been working really. Okay, we're just gonna tap this, and we're gonna keep making our way towards pier. Duct tape on the ground. So you'd never spot that duct tape without this. Look at this. These are clipped in through the floor. Chlorine actually is something that would go towards something good, but I just don't have the space to carry it. I want to leave that spot for a mag, so if we do have to shoot, we've got, you know, we can reload the mag and not just drop it on the ground. Because I don't have the battle mags insured, because I couldn't afford it. Like, nothing, the ACR's not insured, you know, the only thing that's insured that I'm wearing, I think, is the armor? I'm not sure what else. We also need to go to reserve and kill a few more scav, try and get some lower half masks. I mean, we can get them from anywhere. Doesn't matter where we get the lower half masks from. I think we just need to kill two or three more scavs. On reserve, possibly. I think that's how many there is that we have left. I'm gonna chill here for a sec, let ourselves get some stam. Holy shit, there's a lot going on down there, man. I have to try and get closer, but I have to be in cover. There's like three boys down here. One. That's a better grenade. Okay, he's over to the right. I'm trying to influence him to push. What a peek. Okay. Are we good now?
You're gonna pay for this bullshit!
Other guy saw a bear in this area.
Holy shit! Oh, bro, you got a mutant? Oh, fuck. I actually hate when you kill all these guys, because I really want his gun. You got one. I'll take the mutant for a start. I'm not gonna worry about the ammo. I'm just gonna squeeze quickly at these guys as shit. One had a pilgrim. He was back here somewhere. I want to take his pilgrim. Is it you? No. Okay. What do you have, real quick? MK fucking 17. Okay, we gots to go. We gots to get the fuck out of here. We're way down to shit. We gotta still do these. We gotta still run over the bodies and grab Mark this. Just listening for footsteps. I can't believe they were all there. Was that a group of four PMCs? That was a four-man group. Soloed the shit out of them. Alright, let's get out of here. We gotta make our way back. Oh god, what's the closest extract to us? Honestly, not many. I got so much shit. It's the one time I really wish Pier was up, because this is the one time I really needed it, because we're so weighed down by all the crap. We're going to basically have to walk it. And I'm scared that I'm going to get attacked on my way to extract as well. We've got all this shit. I'd cry. I might end up having a slight mental breakdown. More making sure I grab the dog tags than anything else. Like, we've got 700 meters of potential chance to get shot. And we've got to go past a few areas to get there. I want to try and just get myself off the road. That's why I'm running. Myself down in some cover so we can make our way over to there. Seeing what I got left. It's always funny to me how so many PMC bots end up with rangefinders on an assault rifle. Very weird thing. Doesn't make a lot of sense, and it's also blocked by the sight with the way it's set up. I know the bots can just, it's like a randomized assortment sometimes, but far out, man. What a weird loadout. Got anything waiting for us? Not that I can see. Oh, look at so much stuff. Like, and that's the thing. Do I want to keep the guns or do I just sell the guns? Because, like, guns are just whatever. Guns, as long as we got money, we can create any gun we want. I might keep this one because I kind of dig it. I don't know. I'm undecided. Alright, so we can walk while not losing stamp. Because we're at least not heavy breathing now, and we're just walking, so. At least I know I can walk, I don't have to stop. He's running back near here. I really should have a proper look at an updated shoreline map so I can kind of understand the new areas, because I really haven't looked at one, to be honest, at all. I just knew the top left area and some bits back here got done. That was it. A railway bridge extract I don't think I've ever been to. Okay, it's a log. Freaking me out, man. Make our way over there. Hopefully we can get out of here alive, because this has been a big one. I think it's a couple quests plus all the gear. And then plus, like, you know, a 25 or 40% part to other quests. So we've picked up other stuff on the way. So it's been really good. not a big fan of fighting in trenches like this either. If you get yourself pinned down in a trench, you just get clapped from above. There's not too terribly much you can do. You kind of really get yourself stuck in a really bad spot. You guys and girls remember the first time you came along this area and you stepped on a mine? I do. You know what the funny thing was? It took me probably about a year of playing Shoreline with the mines implemented before I ever accidentally stepped on one. And I came through this area many times, but I never accidentally stepped on a mine for some reason. And I think I did it, funnily enough, in a single-player Tarkov video. I never did it on live. Normally because my mates would always warn me, hey, there's mines there, watch out. And then for some reason, I just completely forgot about it and then got myself killed. Gotta be careful as you come up to extract, because bots could be doing the same at the same time, so you can get attacked while you're trying to extract if you're not careful. Now, oh, yep. Nope, I'm sliding down. Guess it doesn't matter. I'm still in the zone.
Oh, what a great raid, dude. Oh my god, that's such a good raid.
Oh, I'm pumped. It was a great fucking raid. I didn't expect all the PMCs at Pier, to be fair. Like, it was a pretty chill raid till we got to there. And then it was just, there's a four-man crew. Just hanging out. Like, I don't know. Oh, so many there. Thank God one of them had a bigger bag. There we go. Nice. Scav, Yusek. That's the name of the mod dev for game panel art. TT. So that's all we ended up getting hit with. We were lucky. Like, we played that very well, honestly. We had a lot of shots fired at us and only to get hit, like, the twice by an ammo that didn't even really pen the armor much is pretty good. Okay, so first things first, quests. Colleagues, part one is done. I need the cottage backdoor key for that. Rigged game is done. Leads to the Huntsman's Path, Sadist, and Night Sweep. As you should have this one. Make sure I hand over anything that I've got stored on my person. Finally, signal is done. Signal part two. Is done. Oh yeah. And now it's jammer time for that. Scout, oh my god, the door. Oh, there's so many quests in this game. Oh my god, like, over the years, Kappa's only gotten more insane if you are able to achieve it. That's the reality of it, right? Like, it's only become harder and harder to achieve Kappa as time has gone on. Can I make them in the hideout? I don't know. Okay, the answer to that is no. We got all this stuff. We got SJ6s and SJ1s, which we need if we go to you and you. No. Hand that in, no. So we just need to do the second SAS disc. And then that one's done. What is that going to lead to? Humanitarian supplies. So what do we need? We need a mule, which I think is only obtainable on labs. Abdolbos, melodonin, no. Okay. So none of the ones that are the ones I just received, I didn't need for that. I need it for assessment. You need 2 of 20. What the fuck? Oh my god. Okay, you gave me the signal jammers, which is beautiful. You lovely man. I'm going to start putting the stuff we're going to sell down here. I'll probably keep that gun, but We need the moolah bad for a lot of this stuff is the reality. So if I don't need it, it's getting sold. Do I need that? I don't need it. I've got 2 of 1. All right, we're also check what Scare gave us. Silence MP5, bunch of Luger ammo. That's pretty nice, not gonna lie. Not too satisfied with that. Okay, so we got this stuff to sell. Making sure she's the highest for a lot of this stuff. Mechanic. Ragman. Gunsmith. All right. We've got nearly a milli. A lot better spot than we were. So task wise for Shoreline. We've got that one, this one. So we need the cottage backdoor key for that. So I'm going to buy 2 of them, which is from you. Intelligence drive is going to cost more than just buying 2 of these. I'm in intelligence folder. I'm going to grab this. No, we don't need that. Now we need to go to Ragman. You, boom, done. Now we've got the MK2 one as well, which can fit a lot of other keys that we have. So I'm going to organize that real quick. All right, I'm also going to grab this because we need it for a mechanic quest. So MK2 will hold all Shoreline and Lighthouse keys for us. And then this key ring's going to be there to store anything we find. If we happen to find anything that's not related to the maps we already have key rings for. Okay, so we need to find a key tool because I really don't want to pay an exorbitant rate for it. So this will allow us to carry the MK3s in there, but I think we can't put them in the key ring. That sucks. So this will allow us to have every key in the game between these 3 key rings. And then you can put them all in a key box so they only take 1 slot. But I brought the MK3. It only took 3 more gold chains and a Tarkoan Director's Key. This allows us to put the Streets Reserve and Labs keys. So that'll do that. This does Ground Zero, Factory, Woods, Customs, Interchange, and Miscellaneous. So we should have everything we need in theory. Now we needed 216. As well. It's an expensive key, man. My God, it's an expensive key. All right. I believe that was right. Yeah, it's the west side. Jeez, could have given me a better spawn. It's not really where I want to be. It's about as far away from the resort as I could possibly get. We'll try and make our way over to Eagle-Eyed as well before we head there. Although, yeah, no. And then we'll probably go out road to customs maybe or something. Pier's not open, unfortunately. So, that's not an option for us. That would have been convenient to go grab Sanitar's stuff, though. We got anybody up? No idea. Don't think so. Either that or bust notifiers just stopped working for some reason. I don't know why. But unless they're at the resort, I don't know whether we're going to go to the pier, only because then we have to run away from the pier. Weird light reflections. I thought it was a spotlight, like a flashlight or something. But it appears nobody had a flashlight. I'm going to try and find, like, when we kill Skaz, I've got to remember to loot their lower half mask, potentially. I got to check to make sure to see if they have one or not. Probably shouldn't run so open into the field. Probably should try and be a little bit more cover conscious. In case I do get into a fight, I've got to at least have something to hide behind. That's my biggest thing. Sometimes I start an engagement with no real proper cover before I start the engagement, which is just stupid. Because if I don't hit the shots and kill him with a headshot or something like that quickly, then I'm in big trouble. Just got to get the second motor controller. We could run into some scavs or PMCs over the ridge here, potentially, so... Just gotta play it careful once we get up here. Scope around a little bit and make sure. But we're being careful. Nope. Not careful enough, apparently. Oh my god, I got him. Ooh. He may have had a half mask on, by the way. Looked like he had something on his face. This guy had like a tank helmet on. Did he have anything on his face? Nope. This guy, though. Oh, he had a ghost mask on. Damn it. I need that for collector. Really? Need to take Dr. Disrespect's armor. Takes a couple drinks. Just in case we need food and water at some point in the raid, because last time we were in the raid for a long time, so luckily we had the drink. That means we can go out the co-op extract if we want, because I didn't bring cash with me, like, and, you know, I haven't been bringing cash with me, so now we've got cash with us. So I know I've done that already. Now it's just resort. We've got to go to 216 and 216, what, west? 308. Or 306 east. Because the rest of them are on woods. Stuck on that wood log. I'm not going to lie, if I seem a bit flat as well, I feel like not the greatest at the moment. But I know, like I hadn't done a video for today, so I needed to get one recorded. But I'm not feeling the greatest. I feel kind of crap, so... Just going to be honest with you guys and girls about that. So there's one on the roof here. There's one at the radio tower and then one at the other one, I believe. The other tower. I think that's where all the signal jammers go. So this is west. Looking around. So Sunny's office from memory is in east. So we're gonna go up here anyway, because we're gonna put the signal jammer on the roof, so we'll do that first. Go all the way to the top, place the signal jammer on the roof. And then we'll do skiers and do mechanics. Then we'll leave. Get out of here. Thank God it's just a plant and then you can leave. You have to stand there placing it. I hate placement ones so much. Okay, so I've got to go. Land lease. We need west 216 and then we go to east 306 or 308. Thought I heard footsteps. La vida vida. Checking. Okay, let's get in here. Right. /216. Ha! Hang on, hang on, holy shit. Alright. There's a bit of stuff in here. It's a good room. Oh my god. Adrenaline. Slayers and stuff. Weapon box, which could have some decent stuff in it. Might as well look. Nope. Wow, actually. Pistol. Canyon room. Just gonna check in here to make sure there's no like LEDX hiding in there. Can I check this room? No. Can I loot through it through this room? No. There's people here. Hoping they back up and I can shoot them through the hole in the floor. Who was he fighting? That's what I'm worried about. I think that was the guy I saw, but who was he fighting? Also, where is this fucking vitamins container? Let me get in here for a second. I need health resort key 112, which I don't believe I have. Nope. Cool. Alright, well, we can't grab that, so we don't have to worry about that. We do have to worry about old mate who... I don't know who he was fighting. Well, I think I hear who he's fighting. Maybe. Let's go down. Oh, we're gonna cheat. We'll go down this way. Because we've got to go down here and then downstairs. No, fuck it. There's a dead man there. Still gotta go over that way. Did you get killed by that other man and then he backed up? Take a belt combo rig. You hold way more shit with it. Wait, can I not? I can't go across there. Yes, I can. I have to go around though. Fuck. I just wanted to suppress him long enough that he can't kill me. Holy fuck. Reload the gun. He'll take a second to get to me, so... I'm not gonna have time probably to repair the black here, Maybe I will. I didn't hit a single shot on him, by the way. I just wanted to shoot at him to suppress the shit out of him, so hopefully he would stop firing at me long enough that I could back up. Okay. We're all right. We're all right. Now I'm trying to decide... do about this. Let's go. Oh my god. I know he fucked it up. This sight, man, sometimes is too much zoom. Okay. Believe that was the dude who was trying to rip the piss out of me at the front door. Smashing at me with an OPSKS. That'd be about right. If we take the mag out, it'll be one wide. We can grab it. I'll take his empty mag. We still need to keep doing our thing here. We're not done. Where do we need to go now? Down this way. Trying to be cautious. I think we're good. Had to be a Slayer. Couldn't have been a Lead X. Oh, hello. I'm gonna close this for a memento. I beg to differ. No space for vase. Plenty of space for vase. Actually pick some of this stuff up because I've got the room. I'm gonna pick up an A1 too. See if there's any worth grabbing. Alionka, Alionka, Ali Alionka, Ali Alionka. Is there anything else here that I needed to do? Or that I could actually do, because I don't have 112 to do that one. Oh yeah, hang on. Yep, wait, we needed to go upstairs, didn't we? 308. 308, 308, 308, or 306. That's right, I remember. I don't have that one. I have this one. There we go. We got the motor controller. What do we get down here? Chainlet? Yeah, because all the settings reset. Everything's huge again, by the way. Because of me reinstalling the config, so I need to fix the sizes of all the icons that I had, you know, originally made smaller, and now they're all huge again, so. I haven't done that yet. I shall get there. What do we got in here? We're gonna need a bunch of CPU fans. So I'm checking them more for that than anything else. Anything else in this room worth grabbing? There's a fucking DVL right here. Alright. Seems kind of quiet out there now. So, we need to go there and there. We're not going to probably do Sunny's one. We'll probably go there and there and then go out Railway Bridge. Sounds like a plan. Let's implement it. Let's implement that plan. How heavy are we? Yeah, we're away a bit. Could I have taken that AK with me? Probably. But I didn't, so, you know. Okay, like I said, move cover to cover. It's a smarter way to play it. Don't try and run out in the open for long periods of time, especially because I don't have... I'm weighed down. I'm not going to have stam to be able to do that all the time. I am worried about if we, when we go to these places, that there's going to be bots there potentially because of questing bots. They are weighed down a lot. That's not worth holding on to. HP ammo, gross. I don't even want it. Okay. Lighten the load a very small amount. The 20k doesn't matter that much to me. Surviving this raid matters more to me. I'm getting out of here with trying to get signal done. You know what it's like, you know, you go in, you could say, I'm going into quest and that, but when you find items for future quests, especially that, you know, it's like, you gotta just get them. You can't not. It's also starting to get dark. I'm not a big fan of. Because I don't have night vision or anything, and I don't have a torch on my gun. As it starts to get later, there is every possibility that that may become a concern. Alright, so there were people fighting up here last time, last raid, so we've got to be careful as we move up here. We've got a grenade and two flashbangs that could aid us. Is that a weird shadow that was moving that way, or is that a player that moved? Was going up and then moved left to right up here. Okay. Seems relatively quiet. I think we should be fine. I've got to be careful. I want to keep a bit of stamina in case we do get up here and there's somebody we need to fight. Peeking over the edge. Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. I hate being here. I couldn't waste ammo, I didn't have another mag loaded. SVD. Gonna try and top load this mag. Trying to listen for his footsteps. Okay, it's getting dark, he's gonna be hard to fucking see. I wanna loot that guy, but I think it's best we just move away. I don't know where he is, it's getting dark, it's safer for me to move away and try and get my way up there, get this signal jam in place and get the fuck out of here. To be honest, if he's got an SVD, he's got range on me as well, so I just want to get, like, point blank you'd think, oh yeah, it's probably better if I hit him point blank when he's got an SVD, but he'll just probably chest spam the shit out of me, is the reality. And I know it's getting darker for you guys and girls also on YouTube, so if you give me a memento, I just want to make sure I don't get shot, so we're going to hide in the bush here. Okay, I've boosted the gamma for you guys and girls. So hopefully you'll be able to see easier. You know what? Fuck the signal jammer. We're gonna die. We've actually got stuff on us that's kinda good and we've done a little bit of questing. Assuming I've done the things I needed to do for this. Yep, alright. And he gives me a GPU. I see them up there. All right. That's enough for throwing rounds. Kinda wish I'd brought in some form of night vision. We leased, we got a stash. Anything good in it though? Yeah. That's not bad. I'll grab it anyway. I'll sell them. We don't need them. There's a fucking grave there. Railway bridge is calling me. It's saying, get the fuck out, Phoenix. You don't wanna die with all these quest items on ya. By some man with an SVD who you can't even see. Oh man. I'm going delusional. You know, sometimes it goes right and sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes you get raids that are really good. I haven't changed any settings, by the way, if you're wondering. I tell you, my shooting needs some work. Like, there's times where I should be hitting headshots and my shooting is way off. And it's almost gonna get me killed if I don't be careful. I know he's gonna start whinging about being out of breath any second now. But if we can get out of here, this is two really good survive shoreline raids, and we have not been surviving shoreline lately at all. Shoreline has been nothing but hell. And to be honest, surviving that four-man PMC fight is that's what I'm more proud of than anything else. We played it so well. Alright. Yeah. And it's frozen. Yeah. Sometimes that happens. It just doesn't show up. Like it's supposed to load this bit and it doesn't work. Alright, we're back. I gotta stop saying alright all the time. I know it's a bad habit because I pause with saying alright and then it's just a bad habit. Really, it's still full of shit. Well, I don't need a second bear, so he's getting sold. I don't need this. I don't know whether I need this. I think I do. Unfortunately, need the vase for a quest later on. That's fine though. Oh, I'm gonna keep a little bit of food and the drinks because they're good to have. But apart from that, all right, we'll do a quick sell job. Bang, 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 bang. Right, and now let's go to task. We can do this. M2. Inside is done, hell yeah. Chemistry closet is done. Lost contact. You, Eagle Eye is done. Now we get humanitarian supplies. We need to mark trucks and hand over MREs so we can craft them. Eliminate Skazwarring, Untar. Ah, yes, the Untar uniform quest. I love that. All right, I'm going to give you another one of them, another one of them. Alright, and then we're going to see what we've gotten. We've got another GPU, which we'll finish off farming for the GPU part of it. We just need CPU fans now. So just need 5 CPU fans. And then farming part 4 is done, which leads to fertilizers, input, and energy crisis, which we've already got. What a peacekeeper give us? A couple sites and some USD. USD's nice. I think that's everything, yeah? Alright. Beautiful. Wow, very successful episode. So anyway, guys and girls, after this extremely long episode, that is going to be the end of it. If you like this video, remember to leave a like. If you want to see more Escape from Tarkov in the future, single player Tarkov, whatever you want to call it, be sure to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to ring the bell to be notified whenever I make a new video. Follow me on all my social media links down in the description below. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope you all have a lovely day. All right, peace. We'll be right back.